you're watching this video, you're probably using Google Sheets and you're wondering how you can rotate the text in a cell similar to how you do it in Excel, or maybe you're just wondering because you have a need for it. You might want to do it for your row headers. There's not a straightforward way to do it. There's no easy way to do it through the menus, but there are some workarounds, and I'm going to show several of them to you right now. They each come with their different caveats, so you have to figure out why you're using them to figure out which one that you want. So the first one is just to insert a text box and then rotate the text box. It's not readily apparent actually how to insert a text box in Google Sheets either. So how you do it, you go to insert and then go down to drawing at the bottom, and then in the insert drawing dialog there's a text box option. Choose that, draw your text box, type in the text, and then size it. Now the way to rotate it is using this little handle up here. You want to hover over the circle, hold your left button down, and rotate it as much as you want. So obviously you can even do diagonal with this if you want, and then do save and close, and then put your text in. That's good in that you can rotate it however you want, and that's kind of the behavior that we're used to from using Microsoft Excel if you have. The bad thing is this doesn't actually go in a cell. It floats on top because it's a text box. So you can put it exactly where you want, but the rows aren't going to auto-size. If you add a row on top, it might not shift down. It just doesn't behave like a normal cell. So that could be good and could be bad depending on what you're doing. The next option is that you can type your header in a cell, and then you take that cell and you just make it really skinny. You make it really skinny, and then you have to have on the word wrap. So I'm going to go over the menu to the right, and I'm going to select text wrapping, and then wrap, and that'll wrap the text. Now you notice that made it go down vertically, but the letters are still going left to right, so it's a little bit different behavior. But for better or worse, it does resize the height of the column. And then there's two formulas that you can use, and I'll put these in the description of the video on YouTube, so you can just copy and paste them. But you take this formula, replace the cell where it says text to become vertical. It's in here twice. Replace that text, and I made this formula show by putting a single quote before it. When you take that single quote off, it does its magic, and there it is. So it makes it vertical. When I go into it, it wants to put a little scroll box in it. That's why it's acting weird. So let me make it a little bit larger. And there's the text to become vertical. Same thing. This is just another type of formula. I would use this one personally. It's just shorter. I don't know. After seeing this one, I don't know why you would use the other one, but I put it in there just because it works. And you can see again, I have a little single quote before it, so it's not doing anything here. But you replace this text with your text, and it makes it go up and down. Now the column width doesn't matter here on these two formulas, and that could be makes it a little bit easier than the option of just putting it in a column and making it skinny. The last thing that you can do, and the advantage of this is that there is no formula, but you just do control enter after every character. So if I hit a J or an H, hit a J, hold down control and press enter, it will go to the next line, but still in the same cell. Just do that until you have it all typed. You can do a couple on a line if you want, and then hold down control and press enter. And that way you can get your vertical header. So hopefully out of those five options, you can find something that works for you.